Home fans, Halloween's evening. I'm your host, Anika Chung. I am back with another Laurel and Hardy film reaction, Way Out West, directed by James Horne. Film fact! Did you know in the scene where Ollie forces Stan to eat his hat, the hat was actually made of licorice? Stan's old friend, Charlie Chaplin, did the exact same trick when he ate the shoe in the Gold Rush in 1925. As the story follows, Laurel and Hardy are looking for a girl named Mary Roberts to tell her of her father's death and deliver her a huge inheritance, including a deed to a gold mine that the father left her. They find Mary at the cabaret in the West, but the owner of the cabaret and his wife, who are Mary's legal guardians, and do not seriously care about her as a person. In fact, they're often being rude and belligerent towards her. And on top of that, they're trying to take over her wealth. These are some shady ass people. Will Laurel and Hardy succeed and get that deed from the imposters? Let's find out in Way Out West. Roll the clip, roll, and action. Laurel and Hardy. This music brings a smile to my face. From 1927 to 1940, Laurel and Hardy made a marvelous short subjects and feature films at the Hal Roach Studios, earning praise in the greatest comedy team ever produced by a movie or television the world never stopped laughing. Indeed, they definitely entertain us to this day. I love this kind of music. It truly adds that joy, that pep in your step. And I like the fact that this production company has restored these older films from 1930s and 40s for us to enjoy. I can't help it. On the show, an MGM picture. Hal Roach Studios presents Stan, Laurel, and Oliver Hardy in, drumroll, Way Out West. I love Western films. They're full of adventure, fun, and great music. Pretty cool, it's like a storybook. What is your favorite scene from this film? Let me know in the comments. Oh, it's his production. Okay. Nightingale, Lola, Marcel tonight. Okay. I cut out the music. Such a busy night at the bar. Beer, cigarettes. $1. 10 cents.
Who? And now, gentlemen, always been my aim to give you the best entertainment that money can buy. I have brought here at great expense.
Get a piece of fat and slide off.
Who said that?
Oh my gosh. Alright, he's out.
I'm getting restless.
I gotta look good, don't I?
Yeah, but one of them took a shot at me.
Oh, quit your whine.
Oh, Harry.
They don't like you. That's why.
Look at all this one horse tank.
Come on, Harry.
How do I look?
Like a million. Come on. She's the lucky one being married to a swell girl like me.
Will you be my lovely darling?
That's me.
My little honey man. I'm living alone.
See my husband?
Yeah, there he is over there.
Won't you be my own star? My little turtle dove.
Will you be my
That was funny. Here they come. He's happy, sleeping in the sun. Poor mule.
Why don't you watch where you're going?
Yes, keep him cool. He left you behind. I knew he was tired. I love what he does. He's like, Oh my goodness. They're in desperate need to get into town. At least that worked, right?
It's only 4 months to Christmas. You believe in Santa Claus?
She looks uncomfortable. I can tell. It's so crowded. Brushwood Glutch? Hmm. Interesting name.
I saw that place. Come.
That's it. Darling! Not you. I meant my husband.
Have a nice trip, Laurie.
Lovely. Until these two came aboard. And they've done nothing but annoy me all the way here.
Good. You run along home.
Goodbye.
Fiddling, huh? Well, we don't like your kind around these parts. And there's one thing we don't allow. And that's messing with our women. Now, if you want to stay healthy, you better catch the next coach out of town.
Why, yes, sir. We'll be glad to. Just as soon as we're finished with our business.
And if you miss the next coach, you'll be riding out of here in a hurry.
Jeez, man.
Good day, stranger. Good day.
So mean.
Bye. Well,
enough alone. Anyone knows who these singers are? Let me know in the comments. I can tell they like the song. This is irritating. I think I remember this scene from the movie Stan and Ollie. I do.
Supposed to tell anybody but her. See, didn't we, Ollie?
A gold mine?
It's the biggest thing that
now that oh my goodness.
Into our confidence.
Spill the beans!
You might as well know the rest. We've got the deed to the property, and we're supposed to get it to her in person.
What?
I said we've got the deed to the property at Paul.
Oh my gosh.
Better show it to him. Maybe he doesn't believe us. It's the truth. Say, did I give you the deed? Oh, I know where it is. Excuse me.
Where did he put it? There's a hole in the shoe?
Find it for you. Don't tell a soul about it till I get back.
We won't. Thank you. Good thing we found it.
Oh my gosh.
Boys, we've got a fortune right in the palm of our hands.
What do you mean?
Of desertbacks downstairs looking for Mary Roberts.
What about it?
They've got a deed to a very valuable gold mine left to her by her father, and they're here to deliver it to her in person.
Well, ain't that just grand?
It would be if you were Mary Roberts.
I got you, but I'd never get away with it.
Sure you would. They've never seen Mary Roberts.
Then it's a cinch.
She is such a sneak. She's an imposter. The Mary is a woman that worked in the kitchen. Oh my gosh. Really? He's putting his meat in the shoe. What a jackass he is.
Just sit yourself down and I'll go and get Laura. I mean Mary for you. I've already told her the news and she's terribly shocked. Laura, they're here.
Swell, kiddo.
Put these in your arms.
She's so fake.
Tell me about my dear daddy. Is it true that he's dead?
Well, we hope he is. They buried him.
Oh, it can't be. What did he die of?
I think he died of a Tuesday. Or was it Wednesday? Do you remember?
I'll handle this delicate situation. Little lady, you've heard the worst. Now prepare yourself for the best. Now cheer up. Smile. That's right. Remember, every cloud has a silver lining.
That's right. Any bird can build a nest, but it isn't everyone that can lay an egg. Is it, Ollie? That's right.
Do you realize that you own one of the richest gold mines in the world? Oh. Your father left you the whole property. And he gave me the honor of presenting you with the deed.
Oh, isn't it wonderful, Uncle Finn?
Yes, my dear. Who's there?
Mary.
Mary who? Merry Christmas.
Jeez.
Excuse me, Mr. Finn. One of these gentlemen dropped us at the foot of the stairs.
Oh, my. Thank you, little lady. You don't know what you've done. Thanks.
All right.
There you are. Signed, sealed, and now delivered.
Oh. Thank you so much.
Not at all. I'm sorry, we'd better be going.
Yeah. Oh, say, what about the locket?
That's right.
I have something else for you.
I almost forgot it.
Karma. I believe in karma for those two.
And besides that, your father left you this family heirloom.
Oh, yes, I remember it well.
Help me get it off, sir.
So tight. Poor Hardy.
No. Just a minute. Won't be long.
You just need some soap, man. Some oil. That'll do the trick.
Maybe I'd better find out for the thing. I think so.
All of this just for this heirloom. It's on the floor.
Just a moment.
It's on the floor.
Hey, Ollie.
What?
Now that you've got your clothes off, why don't you take a bath?
Would you mind leaving the room?
Can't I ever have a little privacy?
I was just trying to kill two birds with one stone.
And I'll take care of those two bozos and get them out of town.
Don't worry. Leave everything to me. I've done pretty good up to now, haven't I?
You certainly have. I wish you were in my shoes. Or how about a drink on the hop?
What a witch.
How'd you get dressed so quick?
None of your business. Goodbye, Miss Roberts. And thanks for the use of your boudoir.
You're very welcome.
Goodbye. Now that you've got the mine, I bet you'll be a swell gold digger.
Don't.
What's the name?
I'll send it back up. You have a fine night, you do what you ask.
Oh, don't worry about me. Get those guys out of town and pronto.
All right.
What a scent.
Give the gentleman the best in the house.
Yes, sir.
I'll be back in a minute.
On a mountain in Virginia stands a lonesome pine. Just below is the cabin home of a little girl of mine.
My name is June, and very, very soon she'll belong to me. For I know she's waiting there for me beneath that lone pine tree. In the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia, on the trail of the lonesome pine, in the pale moonshine, a horse and wine, where she carved her name, and I carved mine, or June, or June, just like the mountain, the blue, like the pine, I am lonesome for you.
Song.
Trail of the lonesome pine
in the Blue Ridge Mountains of name, and I carve mine, oh June. Like the mountains, I'm blue, like the pine, I am lonesome for you.
That was hilarious. Well, at least he's happy, right? What a witch.
Miss Lola, what is it for? Now whatever we do on your behalf is legal.
Oh, thank you very much.
Oh, don't mention it, darling. I won't lie long with your work.
Karma for you! Yes, for her. Don't you just love terriers? What? Hold up.
Did you hear what she said her name was?
Sure, Mary Roberts.
How can she be Mary Roberts when we've just given the deed to Mary Roberts?
I don't know.
I smell a rat.
I smell something too.
Y'all need to do something.
Pardon me. Did you ever have a father by the name of Cy Roberts?
Well, yes. He left me here with these people years ago when he went prospecting.
Well, who's that woman upstairs?
That's Laurel myself, Mr. Finn's wife. She's my legal guardian now.
Mm-mm. Poor Cinderella. Y'all, do something! Don't just stand there!
You know what? What? I think we've given that deed to the wrong woman.
That's the they have.
Since that guy sold us the Brooklyn Bridge.
Oh, buying that bridge was no mistake. That's going to be worth a lot of money to us someday.
Well, maybe you're right. We'd better go and get the deed.
Say, maybe they won't give it back to us.
What do you mean they won't give it back to us? We'll get that deed or I'll eat your hat.
That's what I call determination. Come on.
Splendid. Are y'all?
Splendid.
Mortal Kombat!
Lola, my girl, we're sitting pretty. Who's there?
Me.
Me who?
Me who?
What do you want?
Out of my way, you snake in the grass.
You toad in the hole.
Oh, my gosh.
Say, Miss Blunt, what do you mean busting into like this?
We want to know why you are not Mary Roberts.
I'll take care of this matter.
So you got wives, huh? Well, if it's a teacher, you're just out of luck. Good night,
that. Oh my gosh. Mortal Kombat!
Thank you.
She is so determined. Really? That's some serious back muscles they got just to push that bed up. He's still laughing. Again?
You two dudes to catch the next coach out of town.
Yes, sir.
Well, it left 10 minutes ago.
It did?
Well, maybe we'd better try and catch it.
Run, man. Jeez. That was hilarious. This film was entertaining to watch. Laurel and Hardy never disappoint. I found the story to be brilliant and fun. They ended up giving the deed to the witch who pretended to be Mary. I'm glad they both met the real Mary in time and get the deed from imposters before it was too late. One of the funniest scenes was Laurel being tickled and laughing nonstop. He was laughing longer than Elmo. And I couldn't help laughing too because it was hilarious. And most of all, I enjoyed their singing and dancing. I think the dancing number was actually hilarious. I just couldn't stop laughing. It was kind of cute at the same time. They were just being in the moment. I've only watched this about half an hour and I'm definitely hooked. I can't wait to watch completely later on. And what is your favorite scene? Let me know in the comments. I'm your host, Anika Chung, and I'll see you next time on my next music and film review. Love yourself always, and remember y'all, be excellent to each other. Alright guys, I'll see you next time in the pictures. That's all folks, and that is a wrap. There guys, hello's evening!